Country star Travis Tritt is the latest musician to come out against the jab mandates, taking a stand, saying he's going to put his money where his mouth is. We're going to get into all the details of this and much more, guys. First, if you could, please like this video, share it, hit the bell, subscribe, and wear the glasses because I'm blind. Also, if you could, guys, consider making a generous donation here to our ministry as we're demonetized on YouTube. They don't support us. You can help us out in a major way, though, if you enjoy the daily video content we put out talking about end time Bible prophecy headlines and our ministry here of getting people to Jesus Christ. You can help out through PayPal or Patreon, even just $5 a month on Patreon to get you bonus content. Plus, we include the links to the YouTube videos so you get all alerts when new content arrives. You can comment there, censorship-free, send me direct messages. It's a great way to stay up to date with all the content that we're putting out here. Another big reminder, sub to me on Rumble. That's our backup in case we're kicked off of YouTube. We're already posting there, so go check it out. All the links are down below. A big thank you to everybody already contributing, and for those of you thinking of doing so, thank you as well. Your generosity is greatly appreciated. So Travis Tritt coming out, releasing a statement just the other day, as a matter of fact, saying that officially as of now, any show, any concert that he was booked where that venue is requiring proof of the jab or people having to show a negative test or making people wear face diapers, he is canceling his concerts for those venues. Now, this really goes in line with what Eric Clapton had said many months ago as well, that he would not perform any shows, any concerts that required fans to have to show proof of a jab to get into the show. With Travis Tritt, though, this one is taking it even further. This one, he is saying that no Rona restrictions whatsoever. He will not play at any single venue. Because, you know, some are offering, you know, negative testing as another option, or you'd have to wear the face diaper for the entire time. And he says, no, I'm not even doing that. I'm not going to play any of these venues. If you have any restrictions whatsoever, I'm sorry, but the concert is going to be canceled. Tritt went on to say that he has been against mandates from the start. He said that he respects freedom. His fans being able to attend these shows without the stress or the worry of having to deal with any of this. He says, because it's all a chore. None of it should be something that's put on the people who are paying their hard-earned money to come watch him perform a show. And you know what? He's absolutely right in what he's saying. He's not settling. And I love that, because you could easily just compromise and say that, okay, I'm not going to play at the ones that require proof of the jab. But he's taking it further than that. He's going with all restrictions. And I think that's great. And I think that anybody that's a fan of Travis Tritt, you know, if you like country music and you want to go to one of his shows, maybe you're a little upset that if this happened to be a venue that was requiring all these restrictions or implementing them and that show got canceled, you might not have enjoyed the show as much anyway, having to go through all of that. But Tritt said that right now what his team is doing is that they are looking into other venues right now that are around those same areas. He actually admitted, he says, there's plenty of venues out there. There's promoters that actually believe what, like I do, and like so many of his fans do, where they respect the fans and they respect freedom, and they're not about imposing ridiculous mandates on people to get them to come and enjoy a show. So I know they've already canceled concerts. I know in like Pennsylvania and Illinois, I believe in Mississippi as well, a couple of other states. So they're going to try to find venues that are in those same areas that they can go ahead and reschedule those shows for a later date. So I would just say this to you, if you are somebody who was going to be buying tickets for Travis Tritt or already did, I would go onto his website and check the tour date schedule, because those locations that had those restrictions, or at least putting those, implementing them for the fans, those shows are being removed. They're going to be marked as canceled. He's not messing around with this. And again, I think it's great to see more of these musicians, these artists, taking a stand and letting people know that they are against this. And you know what? They've been coming from really all genres of music. You get Travis Tritt, Eric Clapton, Nicki Minaj. They're coming from all over the place. You got Aaron Lewis, who's kind of on the country side as well, and also the former frontman of the rock band Staind. So there's so many out there, and this is just encouraging to see. Let's hope that we see more of it. They're not going to put up with it anymore. You know, you ask yourself, why is all of this even happening in the first place? Well, it's because we're in the last days and we're getting closer and closer to the return of Jesus Christ. And if you think about it, we're on the doorstep of Revelation chapter 13 in the Bible. You know, when you talk about what you're hearing now about not being able to make purchases without a jab, well, if you go read what Revelation chapter 13 says, the MOTB, and I can't say the full thing for obvious reasons, but you will know exactly where this is all heading. So people are voicing up now because they know what's to come. And that's our ministry here. We want to get people to Jesus Christ. That's why we do these videos and talk about these prophetic headlines. You know, the decision you make to follow Jesus Christ, it's the most important one you're ever going to make. Why not make that decision now? I'll lead you in this prayer. You could do the prayer in your own words, but I'll give you the steps you need to bring that prayer before the Lord. Here's the first thing you want to do. Sometimes it's the hardest, and that's to acknowledge that you're a sinner. It's something that we all are. But the good news is this: God gave his only son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for the sins of all the world. He died and rose again for you and me. He paid the cost. What you have to do is repent of your sin. Repent means to turn from your sin, not just to say you're sorry, but to turn from lifestyles, habits, whatever it is in your life that goes against the word of God. You ask Jesus to forgive you. He'll wipe that sin away. The Bible says he won't remember it any longer. And then you invite Jesus into your life to be your Lord and Savior. When you do that, you become born again, a child of God. You will have eternal life. Trust me when I tell you there is no greater decision you will ever make than the one you do to give your life to Christ. I pray you make that decision today. I'll have more for you guys on this down below. You can let me know your thoughts. Don't forget, the links to donate to our ministry are there as well. It is a great blessing if you could help us out. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I'll be back with more. You guys take care. Please be safe out there. God bless each and every single one of you. And I'll talk with you soon.